Ugh, what a day! We're running late for school. It put my whole family in a bad mood. I didn't even get to eat breakfast. Now my stomach hurts so bad.
You think that's bad, Wendy Weiner? I completely forgot to study for my science test today, and I know I'm not going to do well. Can you say, grounded?
Seriously? That's nothing. There are people who have much more serious worries and problems than you guys. Think about it. We know there are really hard things that kids our age, maybe even some of us, will have to go through.
That's right, young lady. I couldn't help but overhear you whippersnappers from my post here at the common security desk. Whether it's something big or small that you're dealing with, it's important to remember that as a friend of Jesus, you can trust him to be right there with you every step of the way. That's true for all of us, young or young at heart.
It's true. Jesus wants you to come to him, trust him, and give him glory, even in the hard times. You know, let your light shine.
Why is it hard to let your light shine when things aren't going right? We must remember to run to Jesus and hold on tight.
I want to let my light shine even in hard times, just like that song said. But sometimes it seems like a hard thing to do, like when I'm afraid.
Wait, I don't get it. I know that your love for Jesus is your light, but what does being afraid have to do with letting your light shine?
I know exactly what she means. When we are afraid, whether it's afraid of standing alone, when standing up for what's right, afraid of people laughing at you, or anything else that can fill you with fear. It's hard to be brave and continue showing the courage that God would want you to have.
We all have things that we are scared of, no matter how old we are. We should see even the things that fill us with fear as a way to experience God's presence and power in a way that helps us let our light shine.
Wow, that's true. When I think about it, everything seems scarier in the dark, but letting a light shine makes things seem easier to see for what they really are, and in a way, less scary. Shining with the love of Jesus is the way to show others that they don't have to live in the fear and darkness of a world without God's love.
What are things that fill me with fright? Like imaginary things that go bump in the night. God calms my fears and floods the darkness with light.
You were lying in your bed. You were feeling kind of sleepy, but you couldn't close your eyes because the room was getting creepy.
Were those eyeballs in the closet? Was that Godzilla in the hall?
There was something big and hairy casting shadows on the wall. Now your heart is beating like a drum. Your skin is getting clammy. There's 100 tiny monsters jumping right into your jammies.
What are you gonna do?
I'm going to call the police.
No, you don't need to do anything.
What? Why?
Because...
God is bigger than the boogeyman. He's bigger than Godzilla or the monsters on TV. Oh, God is bigger than the boogeyman, and he's watching out for you and me.
So when I'm lying in my bed and the furniture starts creeping, I'll just laugh and say, hey, cut that out, and get back to my sleeping. 'Cause I know that God's the biggest and he's watching all the while. So when I get scared, I'll think of him and close my eyes and smile.
God is bigger than the boogeyman. He's bigger than Godzilla or the monsters on TV. Oh, God is bigger than the boogeyman, and he's watching out for you and me.
So are you frightened?
No, not really.
Are you worried?
Not a bit. I know whatever's gonna happen, that God can handle it.
I'm sorry that I scared you when you saw me on TV.
Well, that's okay, 'cause now I know that God is taking care of me.
I sure am glad she figured out that God is bigger than her fear of the imaginary things in the dark. But not all problems and fears can be solved just by shining a light on them, can they?
Yeah, I mean, I have a real problem, and it happens right out in the bright Florida sunshine. It is a problem many of us face every day. It is... come closer, closer, recess.
Yes, recess. Why is it that we all get along, care about each other, even pray for each other in our classrooms, but the minute we are on the playground, we find ourselves arguing about who plays what, who gets to go first, who was out or safe. I could go on and on.
I can answer that. By now, I think we can safely guess it's because we are not choosing to let the love of Jesus shine on the playground.
That's right. Sometimes it's on the playground. Other times it's at home with our brothers or sisters. And sometimes it's when we are playing with our friends. But we all find ourselves in situations where we only see our side of things. It's a temptation to put our own desires first, to think we are the ones who are right. That's called pride. To truly let our light shine, even out in the Florida sun, we have to shine our light by being like God's son, by putting others before ourselves.
Why do people sometimes fight? Our pride tempts us to think we're always right.
1 John 2, 8-11 and Matthew 5, 16. At the same time, it is a new commandment that I am writing to you, which is true in him and in you, because the darkness is passing away and the true light is already shining. Whoever says he is in the light and hates his brother is still in darkness. Whoever loves his brother abides in the light, and in him there is no cause for stumbling. But whoever hates his brother is in the darkness and walks in the darkness and does not know where he is going, because the darkness has blinded his eyes. Therefore, let your light shine before others, so that they may see your good works and give glory to your Father who is in heaven.
We've learned so much about shining our light, the light that can only come from knowing and loving Jesus Christ. What do you say we review all that we've learned so that we can leave here today ready to shine for Him in life, in our learning and in leadership, with our family, friends, neighbors, and the world?
Remember, when things don't go right,
in the dark of the night,
or even when people are tempted to fight,
God is there to show He cares.
He teaches us to shine His light.
Just went away.
Wow, I feel really enlightened about how important it is to let your light shine for Jesus. See what I did there? That was a good one. Enlightened? Get it?
Good one. I bet we have some friends out there who want to shine their light for Jesus, too.
Hey, that gives me a great idea. Let's give everybody a chance to shine today.
Sounds great. Ladies and gentlemen, boys and girls, in what has become a puppet chapel tradition, please join our cast for one final song.
Yes, you. Come on, FBA students, teachers, family, and friends. Stand and sing with us. Let's let the light of Jesus shine here at FBA for all the world to see.
This little light, gonna let it shine. Let it shine, gonna let it shine. This little light of mine, I'm gonna let it shine.
Hide under a bushel, no.